What's up, people? This is Wingless. I want to talk about tokens. And how or why you'd want to create your own token. And how could you make a token be worth $1 million? How could you have a $1 million economy, a virtual economy? That's what I want to talk about today. Because like so many others, I've created tokens because I thought all you needed was a token and you'd become a millionaire. Just make a token and get people to give you money. It's awesome. It's like the whole new thing, man. All you need is a token. Man, let me tell you, I've created one, the F Trump token. Boom, what a failure that one was. I created the Streets token. Boom, what a failure that was. I've created the B Chain token with Token.io. I'm holding on to that puppy because I don't want to release another token the wrong way. There's a right way and a wrong way, and the wrong way is to just think that you need a token and you'll make money. That's not how you do it. I want to explain to you my thoughts on token and token economics. So this is my theory. Now, I'm not an expert. If anyone says there's an expert in this field, I would just suggest run the other direction. There's no experts here, all right? It's all just a big, huge, we're all beta testers, in my opinion. It's a big, huge beta test. And it's so much fun, and it's so exciting, because there's something always new. So how can you make your token be worth value? My idea is, you can't start off with nothing and expect to raise $1 million. I believe tokens, token economics, are best suited for people that are already providing a good or service, and here's the key, people are directly paying you for this good or service. If people aren't actively right now paying you for your good or service that you're providing to the world, I don't think that you should expect to be able to create a token and become a millionaire. Even with YouTube, if you're making money on YouTube, great job, awesome, I love you, I probably watch your channel, but this is the thing with YouTube, is people that are watching your content are not directly giving you money. You're making money off of advertisements, off of someone else. It's like sponsorship. It's like, I'll give you money if you keep doing what you're doing, and I'm gonna throw some ads in before and after, and I'm gonna give you money for that because you're allowing the platform to give you ads. Tokens are the new way for people to connect across the world, for people to transact, to give value back and forth, to interact with each other financially. I love that. However, right now, me personally, I don't have anyone paying for my good or service. I don't think a lot of people on YouTube are actually giving money. People that have a Patreon account and their patrons and Patreon are actively giving them money every single month, I think those are the people that are primed, that are ready to jump on and create a token, to onboard a token. Another thing about tokens is you need to think of a business plan. It's not just you get a token and expect people to start giving you, you know, money or Ethereum or cryptocurrency. If I would just release a token, and then I'm most excited about EtherVision launching later this year. It's a pay-per-view platform, but that's not the only model. That's not the only economic model. That's what makes me interested in EtherVision and Singular DTV. It's wide open. It's up to you, the individual, to decide how you want your virtual economy to run. So, even if a YouTuber, a big YouTuber, would create a token and then switch to EtherVision and start charging people to watch their content, I don't think that they would be successful. I could be wrong, but people right now aren't paying them. So, to jump off of YouTube and try to get someone to now directly pay you would be risky, in my opinion. what I plan on doing with my token, I think this could change, but my thoughts are right now is I want my token to be an access token. So you just hold my tokens, 5, 10, certain amount of tokens, and you have access to watch my content. And then the content that I think is more valuable, that took me more time, you'll have to hold more. That's kind of what I'm thinking. Now, if a YouTuber wants to create a token and charge people, you also need to be careful of Big Brother, of the United States government. Because I think if you create a token or any kind of virtual asset and you then start producing a good or service and accepting that digital asset that you created as payment, I think the U.S. government would look at that saying that you created currency and now you're accepting it. So you just created currency, gave currency out, and now accepting currency as payment. You need a money transmitter license for that. You can't do that. So that's where it gets sticky. That's where you want to watch yourself. So that's some words of advice, my thoughts. I don't know. Do your own research. What do you guys think about my thoughts? Do you guys want to make your own token? I don't know. Are you guys interested in paying for content? I think it would be cooler to have access tokens. And then the more people that want to watch my stuff, the more people will have to buy my tokens, which then increases the token in value. And then you, the token holder, get rewarded. And if I screw up and make something stupid and everyone dumps and sells my tokens, that's on me. Personal responsibility. I love it. Anyway, I'm home. Peace. Love you guys. Have a good one.